Thank you for allowing me to speak with you this evening. My name is William J. Roche, R-O-C-H-E. I am a stakeholder and landowner at 1353 White Hill Road in Davenport, New York, which my wife and I have the privilege of owning 127 acres. Tonight I want to speak to the original line that was set down, to the issue and my concern that I'll speak about tonight. I've already written for on other issues and I will continue to do so. But tonight I would like to just speak for a second about the concept of safety, environment and safety. I've made my concerns available to, and both gentlemen were equally responsive and polite. And I made them respond. I made my response to Mr. Richard Bell, the Director of Emergency Services of Delaware County, Mr. Kevin Ritten, Coordinator of Office of Emergency Services for Otsego County, and I copied it to Mr. Tom Williams, Representative of Williams and Cabot. Traversing our property and ending at a tower on Tower Road, Davenport, New York, is a bundled cable where the engineer, when we first bought the property some 6 years ago, said to me, I asked him, not what I do for a living, could we move this? And he chuckled. And he said, do you know what is in that cable? And he indicated that the tower and the Verizon fiber optic cable served Delaware and Otsego County Emergency Services, State Police, Ambulance, Verizon, AT&T, Motorola, T-Mobile, NYSIC, local radio, and similar significant properties, that in the event of a natural gas rupture, and someone wins the lottery all the time, they would be incinerated. These lines would be incinerated. It's a very powerful word. That line would be incinerated. Now we're just talking about a line, but we're talking about the ability of Otsego County initially didn't think they were going to be affected. The concept of the word affected landowner, my property, a neighbor, may not think that he or she is affected, but in fact, when I finish with this short scenario here, he and his home and his children are very much more affected, never mind nature. If that natural gas line were to rupture, that line would be incinerated. Given the present routing is well within the blast burn radius. A major threat beyond the actual blast area is the thermal radiation sustained from a continued burn in a heavily forested area of which we're in. That area is protected by a volunteer service. It's sort of ironic and sort of almost humorous that we're giving out $25,000 grants when, if a blast occurred, $25,000, I don't think is going to do the job. In the most credible and worst case scenario, we would lose all our ability to communicate instantaneously. I mean, it's important to consider this. The proposed route should fall into, I think, along certain segments of the route, especially the V coming up off of Oneonta into a high consequence area. The data on a 30-inch pipe operating at 800 PSI with a future maximum PSI of 1440 has a burn area of 525 feet academically. In the hospital I work at, in my research lab, we have a little sign that says, in God we trust, everybody else bring data. Well, history is a part of data. So when we look at the 30-inch, and let's do apples and apples, when we look at the 30-inch line blast in Milton, Virginia, that was in 1975, the burn radius was actually 725 feet at less than 800 PSI, much less than the potential of this line. In actuality, the blast burn area was 75% greater than the data reported by the Gas Research Institute data reported in Jackson, Louisiana. That was operating at 1,016 PSI when it ruptured and was reported to burn an area of 1,450 feet long and average 360 feet wide, with the furthest burn in the rupture reported at 950 feet wide. The blast burn radius was greater than 45% of the data presented by the Gas Research Institute. In Lancaster, Kentucky in 1986, the PSI was 990 and it burned an area that was reported to be 900 feet by 1,000 feet. Two houses, one house trailer, and other structures were incinerated. There's that word. It's a very powerful word. They're not now just incinerating the communication line. Now we're going to incinerate houses, animals, and I think that's what you're asking for, is safety and environment. The explosion created an asymmetric crater of 167 feet long, 26 feet wide, and 40 feet deep, and through sections of pipe that were recovered 100 feet away from the blast and measured at 28 feet. It took 60 to 90 minutes to turn off the gas. Eight deaths, 38 residencies were incinerated. The fire comprised the water main. It compromised the water main, making it necessary for ordinary citizens to drag hoses 4,000 feet. This can go on and on. There are lists of 30-inch pipeline catastrophes. And I think that when you look at where, so let's get back to the line. The line here goes about 15 feet in the air and then goes underground. So when the landsman came, he said, well, we'll just move the line. Okay, that was my initial proposal years ago to move the line, and I got chucked. Now, if it goes underground, now it goes underground into a transmission line, that this line comes up the road in Davenport, comes up the road, and it is supposedly now going to go under that line. So, but from what I'm understanding is, we're told that a propane blast goes this way and natural gas goes this way. So one way or another, that line should be considered. And we should consider where we're putting this pipe. My bottom line is, we should consider where we're putting this pipe in relationship to people's lives, our forests, our animals. I hope that you sincerely take that into consideration. I also would like you to take into consideration that in the proposal of M, that when it transverses behind the Nature Conservancy, there is a huge Nature Conservancy there. And the initial proposed line, if you come off that bank and the erosion will go into that bog, there is no question about it. They've stopped using fertilizers in that area. And then there are beautiful, beautiful waterfalls in the back of our property, in the back of the conservatory. There are natural springs that feed from one element into the other. And I would like for you to consider that water empties down into Oneonta. On a beautiful sunny day in the fall, if you sit there, my wife and I found it for the very first time as a little dot on the map. And you could hear it from a half a mile away. And when you get there, it's awe-inspiring to see this water just gushing down the mountain and to know that in M, it's going to transverse that area. I thank you for your time.
Thank you.